All right, good morning. It is Tuesday, week 61. Yesterday was treatment day for the wife, and had to get up early and get her out the door so we get off the treatment, so there was no working out yesterday. Didn't have time, and kind of taking a little break. Last week, like I said, everybody knows that we're working on the house. We're doing a big project in the house, doing the reflooring and doing all the bathrooms. And so last week, as I was squatting, kneeling down, doing baseboards and doing floors and stuff, it felt like someone stabbed me in my left quad, and it hurt like hell. And I developed a very, not a bruise or anything, but a very deep, deep muscle tension in my left quad. It hurt just to stand, it hurt just to walk. And that was after I had done legs that day. So I think I just overstrained my legs, and then my left quad just said he had enough, and he just seized up on me. So I'm still working on that issue right now. So today's workout is just gonna be all upper body, can be no legs. I'm gonna go in and do some more foam rollers on my legs when I'm done here. That's gonna be my leg workout. I need to get my legs back to being healthy again. I've really been pushing them hard, and they're actually misbehaving right now because I'm not taking care of them. So I need to start taking care of them a little bit more, do some more muscle relaxation and soothing the muscle after I'm doing the workouts. So this is week 61, and this project in the house that we've been working on has really been taking its toll on me mentally. Not only doing all the work, but also taking care of my wife who is disabled. So by the end of the day, my stress level is like way up here. And my stress level's up there. I'm not thinking about fasting. I'm not thinking about nothing else. I'm thinking about going and getting me a couple tacos and a beer and just sitting down and just chilling and relaxing after I've spent all day long working in the house and then having to stop to take care of her. And that's just the way my life goes. So these past couple weeks, I have not been very dedicated to my diet, and it's made me mentally not really feel great, but I'm trying to get this project done in the house so that we can move on to another project that maybe not as stressful, but also so that she can have the flooring and the bathrooms done is what she wants. So that's what we're working on. So coming out here and getting my workouts on, whether I'm fully on my diet or not, doesn't matter. I still like getting my workouts on. I still like being healthy. I still like feeling strong. That mentally keeps me centered. When my diet is on and I'm actually feeling good and I'm fasting and I'm doing my OMAD and everything, I'm feeling 100%. When I'm overstressed because of all of the amount of stuff that I'm dealing with, going out and having a beer and having some tacos after I've been working all day, that makes me feel more relaxed and gets me ready for the next day because I know I'm gonna have the same workload the next day. And I am retired, so I don't want a workload. But that's the workload that I got right now. So I'm trying to get this project done so I can get back to my workouts so I can find another project that maybe she wants to put me onto. So today's workout is just gonna be all upper body. We're gonna do chest press, we're gonna do overhead press, we're gonna do triceps, and then I'm gonna go in the house and I'm gonna do foam rollers on my legs so that I can relax them. And then we're gonna get into doing more work in the house, more bathroom work, more stuff. We're waiting for sinks to come in, for faucets to come in. We got the big vanity in, and we got a big mirror. Then I need to paint the whole bathroom and put up the stuff that she wants before we get that done. And the sinks are coming in next to the sinks. The faucets are coming in next week. We had to special order those. Really cool looking faucets that she really liked, the open channel ones that come out really nice and pretty. So we're waiting for that to come. And while we're still doing the floor through the house, putting the baseboards in, we're doing a lot of work. And it's just me and my brother who's coming over and helping. He's the master and I'm just the assistant. But I still have my work to do and then taking care of my wife. So it is a long, arduous task that we're doing right now. So coming out here in the morning, get my workouts on, mentally prepares me for the day, and we're gonna get it going. So let's go. All right, some yellow band today. Oh. 15 good pushes to start. All right, no crossovers today. We're going to black band presses. Finish that fatigue level out. Ooh. 20 solid pushes with the black, and it was 10 seconds to change over from the black band to the yellow band. I don't know why I turned the camera off, just automatic. I should have just walked over, grabbed the black band and done it, but that was the break in between, about 10 seconds. Take the yellow off, put the black on. All right, shoulders. I got two bands down here, so we're gonna try a double band destruction today. We're gonna start off with the light gray, standard standing and kneeling. Then I have a red band, which is right below the white band. And I'll try and finish off standing and kneeling with that. Ugh. 52 total. The light gray felt strong. I felt really strong doing all the way up to what, the 27 standing. Then once I knelt, everything gone. When I switched over to that yellow, or that red band, which is one below the white band, I wanted to try and keep the elbows in closer and really concentrate on pushing with just the shoulders and really trying to tire those out. Oh my God, just doing that hurt. So I kind of like that double destruction. I burned it out with the heavier bands and then really, really try to stay in form and concentrate on just using those muscles only with that lighter band. Whew. All right, tricep destruction coming up. All right, let's finish up with some triceps. Then we can get in there and get our legs on the foam roller and cry in agony as I try and loosen those tight spots up. One of the things I like about the tricep, once you start getting tired and your tricep is totally filled with blood and totally pumped, you just sink into that zone where it's just your rubber band against the rubber band you're pushing. And it's like you're going back and forth with your rubber band, which is your tricep, against that rubber band. And you're just sinking that zone and just going back and forth nice and slow. And that really pumps it. Whew. All right, that's it for Tuesday morning, week 61, push day. Felt good, I felt strong. It felt good taking a couple extra days off Monday, or was it Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday? Yeah, I think I took those 4 days off. Felt really good. Mentally, I wasn't liking it. I wanted to get back out here and work out. But it's good to let your body rest. And like I said, I ended up, it's like in the upper thigh right here, I was squatting down to put some baseboard down in the bathroom. And it felt like someone just horse kicked me right in my quad, and I almost collapsed to the ground. And then all of a sudden I just developed this serious sore spot right in here, right in the quad. It was just really painful to the touch. Just walking alone would make it hurt. It's gotten a lot better, not super sore right now, but I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna do the foam roller on both my legs, trying to loosen up some of that tissue that's really been overused lately. I've been really pumping my legs. I got skinny stork legs, so trying to put any size on them is work. My body is just kind of, although I got some mass on me, it's still kind of a lean, very lean body. I don't have very compact muscles like a lot of people do. I have more lean, longer muscles. So in order for me to put on any size, I really have to work hard. And that's what I'm doing, because I enjoy it. I actually enjoy the workouts more than anything. So today's workout, like I said, was simple. I did double chest, I did double shoulder, and I did double tricep. And then I'm gonna go and do my legs. Tomorrow, we'll see how I feel. I wanna let everybody know that I have started another channel. For me, sleeping at night, sometimes it's kinda hard to go to sleep, and I need something to calm myself. And I see all those relaxation videos and stuff like that, and I decided to make my own. So I have my own channel. It's called Be Relaxed, and it's got a picture of a owl up in it, and I'll put the link down below for anybody that wants any soothing, relaxing rain, water, waterfall, ocean waves, whatever. I've only got two videos or two so far, and I'm working on adding a bunch more to it, things that relaxes me. I know one of the things that relaxes me is a crowd noise at a baseball game or a football game. So that's probably gonna be the next one I work on. I just love hearing that noise in the background. It just really pushes me to sleep. So anytime I'm watching a baseball game or football game sometimes, unless it's an exciting game, I'm ended up dozing off because that noise just really puts me into a nice relaxed state. So that's probably gonna be the next one I'll work on probably tonight or tomorrow, work on adding that one to my channel. I plan on adding a ton more of those relaxation videos to help me relax, focus, or put the earphones on and just at a time you want to take a nap or when you're going to bed at night. So some of these videos are anywhere from 6 to 9 hours long, so you can play them all night long or whatever is best for you. So this is working for me, and I like creating my own, so I can go into where I'm getting the stuff at, and I can create my own sounds and my own things that interest me. If you like it, subscribe, and I'll be adding more. So that was it for today, week 61. We'll be back out here again tomorrow for pull day of week 61. I got it done. I'm gonna go live my life. I'll see you tomorrow.